I mean, in the beginning, I just tried to talk myself out of starting this business because it really didn't make sense in that time of the world. But the more I looked into climate change, the more I understood what a humongous problem it is going to be. And I just had no choice. About 2 years ago, nobody was really interested. They didn't think that it would be a good business. They didn't really see the money in it. That's all changed so rapidly. Everybody and their grandma is calling themselves a climate investor now, which is fantastic. I'm Henrietta Moon. I'm the CEO and co-founder of Carboculture. And Carboculture is removing atmospheric carbon by turning biomass waste into highly stable carbon that remains stable for 1,000 years. Most life on Earth is carbon, and it's our fourth most abundant element, so it's not bad per se. We just have it in the wrong place in too much scale. So we need to think of the most elegant way to actually bring down that carbon from the atmosphere and put it to use somewhere where we can use it better.
This challenge is at the core of Carboculture's mission. The Helsinki-based startup is focused on solving the Earth's carbon problem while offering a viable business model, one that didn't even exist at the beginning of her career.
I ended up in this crazy program that was a three-month intense program at NASA Ames in California, and that's where I met my co-founder, Chris Carstens. Back then, there was no price on carbon. Emission trading was at maybe €5 a ton, and nobody was really interested in pursuing that as a business model. We got started properly in 2017. Today, the carbon market is trading at over 10 times that, so times have changed.
Henrietta and her team turned to nature itself for inspiration on how to make this model both effective and profitable.
Every year, nature draws down carbon in the form of photosynthesis into all our biomass, trees and plantations and crops and everything you see. But naturally, when that biomass, like the trees, die, they decompose and re-enter the atmosphere again. And that's the natural carbon cycle. At Carboculture, we were trying to figure out what is the most elegant way to actually draw down some of this carbon. And instead of trying to invent machines to take out parts per million from the atmosphere, we decided that millions of years of nature already knows how to do it. So if you see a forest today and in 500 years, it'll essentially be the same size. It's not going to 10x its carbon removal capacity or grow 10 times larger. So we have these solar-powered allies who use photosynthesis and turn this carbon from the atmosphere into biomass. And we take that biomass, such as nutshells or peach pits or tree waste, and we put it into our patented reactor, and we rapidly take it to ultra-high heat where it carbonizes. It doesn't decompose, it's not eaten by microbes or anything, and we can store it safely in the soil. By doing this, the carbon that's almost pure carbon remains stable from 1,000 years to, let's say, maybe up to 1,000,000 years.
Their first facility resides in California, which operates as a proof of concept to demonstrate the process.
Basically, we put biomass in there and we put them inside. We take them to an ultra high temperature, about 1,000 degrees Celsius for a split second. And in that time, the biomass carbonizes. So it turns into a charcoal-like form. You can mix it into compost or put it in the soil or use it for water filtration or just bury it in the ground in an old mine shaft or something. Our technology is like, on a basic level, the same thing as turning wood into a carbon is something that everybody can do in their home fireplace, right? But now if you want to make it like ultra, ultra, ultra efficient and actually store the carbon away, now it gets a little bit more difficult. But the kind of principle is the same. Right now, our batch takes about 2 hours for a half a ton, so we can do about 500 pounds per hour, let's say, of biomass.
Now that they've mastered the concept, it's really just a matter of scaling it up by a factor of 1,000,000 or so.
If we put 1,000,000 of these systems around the world, we can actually use part of the energy in the biomass itself to power these systems. And in this way, we're helping the green transition of the grid instead of hindering it. This next scale up at scale would remove about 13,000 tons of carbon dioxide annually. So make a few thousand tons of biocarbon. And that's a big step for us.
Though Carboculture has recently raised $6.2 million in seed financing, it will take a lot more funding to get Carboculture's vision to scale. This Herculean effort will require investments from both public and private sectors. And now that carbon capture programs like this are beginning to get traction, Henrietta welcomes the competition.
If we look at the big picture, we have a North Star mission of a gigaton of removal, which is 1 billion tons. And it's a real insanity target. It's definitely not easy. It's light years away from where we are today. But for us, it means that we also need to get to that kind of a scale. And there's probably going to be 10 to 100 companies like us in maybe a decade from now that will be trying to get to that gargantuan scale that is needed.